Today, I will show you how to export your photos from Lightroom and from Photoshop for Facebook. Hello YouTube, welcome back to the channel. My name is Erwin and this channel is all about photography and photo editing. Don't forget to subscribe down below. If you do so, don't forget to hit that little bell notification next to the subscribe button. Today it's about showing your images. Showing your images to the world is very important and you need to do this the right way. So, for example, on Facebook. First of all, we need to know what size Facebook recommends for the images. So, let's get a browser and I'll show you where to find this information. And after that, I will show you how to do the export in Lightroom and Photoshop. Let's get started. Now for this tutorial, let's take this image of my buddy Rob. We did the shoot a couple of weeks ago and I want to post this image to Facebook. The largest photo you can upload to Facebook is 2048 by 2048 pixels. And the maximum display size in landscape is 960 by 720. However, if you view an image in full screen mode, it can appear up to the maximum upload size of, yes, you guessed it, 2048 by 2048 pixels. If you upload images to Facebook larger than the maximum upload size of 2048 pixels, Facebook will compress your images. This will mean you will get all kinds of unsharp artifacts, pixelating of your image, etc, etc. We've all seen that and that's probably why you are watching this tutorial. Now first of all, I will show you how to properly export your image in Photoshop. We have this image of Rob here, as I told you a few seconds ago, and we want to export this for Facebook. Now we need to keep in mind that the longest edge, which is here, can only have a maximum size of 2048 pixels. Let's remove this text again. Photoshop has a real nice export suite, which you can find under File, Export, Export As. Now a new window will open and you will see your maximum size of your image is the full resolution of my sensor. Now first of all, I want to export as JPEG. I want an image quality of 100%. And I want to export in the width. I want to export with a file size of 2048. It automatically calculates the height and how it's scaled. Now we want to convert to sRGB. Don't forget this, or colors will not appear as they were shown in Photoshop. And now we will hit export all and your photo will be exported for Facebook with the right resolution and the right size. No compressing of your image will appear when you're doing it this way from Photoshop. Now let's dive into Lightroom. We take the same image, but Lightroom makes stuff a little bit easier. Now let's dive into the export module by pressing right mouse on your image when in the library and go to export, and we will open the export window. Well, I've got a preset for this export called social export. The most important settings for this are the image format to JPEG and the quality to 100%. Color space again, make sure you set it to sRGB. Do not limit the file size and resize the image over the long edge and again the 2048 pixels. Keep in mind that the minimum resolutions must be 240 pixels per inch. A better setting is 300 pixels per inch, but I use 240 since most of the users which are watching the photo will use it, will watch it on a mobile device.
and then 240 pixels per inch is more than sufficient. Now, another important step is to add some output sharpening, which will be set to screen, since we will watch this on Facebook, so it's always on a screen shown. I like a very hard sharpening, so I set it to high. Now hit export and your image will be saved at the location you've set in export locations.
That was my tutorial on exporting photos for Facebook. Both ways are fine to use. They give high quality images specifically for Facebook when you follow this tutorial. At the end of this tutorial, I just wanted to mention my free preset pack for Lightroom. You can find a link down below in the description. There's also a video on how to install these presets in Lightroom. There will be a card up here. Leave your questions in the comments. Let me know down below what the next subject for the new videos should be, and maybe I can make a tutorial about it. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.